What's going on, y'all? This is Damien with the DevSec Blueprint, or the DSB for short. And in today's video, I'm basically going to give you guys some tips and tricks on how to effectively pass the Google Cloud Associate Cloud Engineer Certification Exam. So without further ado, let's just get straight into it, right? All right, so before I get into the exam, let's go over the prerequisites. So if you haven't necessarily dibbled and dabbled in the cloud before, or you haven't touched any of the GCP services or Google Cloud services, I would definitely recommend you get the Digital Cloud Leader first before attempting to take this exam, simply because it'll give you an overview of every Google Cloud service that they offer before you get into actually taking this exam. And that's something that I did before I took this exam, and I think it really benefited me. But on the contrary, if you have cloud experience and you have like an AWS solutions architect or, you know, some Azure certifications and stuff like that, then you can definitely just like skip the Digital Cloud Leader and take the certification exam. So now that we've taken care of the prerequisites, let's talk a little bit about this exam. So per Google, an associate cloud engineer deploys and secures applications, services, and infrastructure, monitors operations of multiple projects, and maintains enterprise solutions to ensure that they meet target performance metrics. So when you take this exam, all basically you're going to be set up to be able to deploy and configure and implement a cloud solution using GCP services. You'll be able to set up different projects and different accounts or different projects. You'll be able to ensure the successful operation of whatever it is that you're deploying using some of the most popular services. And you'll ensure that, you know, the operation of whatever solution that you've built and you've developed using the various different services. So the thing about the certification exam is that the length is 2 hours. You know, the registration fee is about $125. And then you have 50 to 60 multiple choice slash multiple select questions. And then these are the various different languages that you can take this exam in. So when it comes to really understanding exactly what you need for this exam, you definitely want to make sure you take a look at this exam guide. And you can see that in the first section, setting up a cloud solution environment is very, very important. This is basically, you know, you going in, you creating a project, you setting up the organization, enabling APIs to be able to use cloud functions and create cloud storage buckets, et cetera, et cetera. So in section two is basically planning and configuring a cloud solution. Section three, you're deploying and implementing a cloud solution, and that's 25% of the exam. So you definitely want to make sure you're getting hands-on. And also the section four is ensuring the successful operation of a cloud solution, which is 20% of the exam. And then you also have the fifth section, which is configuring access and security, which is basically like all things IAM, to be honest. So that's 17.5% of the exam. And so that's a little bit about this exam. All right, so now that we covered the exam and went over the exam guide a little bit, let me tell y'all about the resources that I use. So one key resource that I used was the Google Cloud Associate Cloud Engineer course created by Anthony Tavelas. And I thought it was really well made. It was really well done. It's only about 20 hours. And on top of that, also free on YouTube. And it's basically hosted, or it's associated with, the Free Code Camp's channel. So if you don't want to spend the $20 or the $30 on Exam Pro's website to pay for this course, you can catch it on YouTube for free. And it's actually really, like I said, it's really well made. He goes into detail, he breaks things down, and he's very thorough with his explanations. And he also does hand-on exercises during the course as well. So you can learn how to create compute engine VMs. You can learn how to create cloud storage buckets. You play around with the gcloud CLI and so many different other things. So it's really well made, really well done. Now, when it comes down to taking practice exams, or actually trying to test your theoretical knowledge as you get through the course, there's two things. Number one, if you pay for the course through ExamPro's website, you definitely will get a chance to take the practice exams that's associated with this course. And I definitely went through and paid for the course anyway, because it's hard for me personally to be able to keep track of where I am by just going through YouTube and just taking note of the time codes where I stopped when I studied for the exam. So that's something that I ended up doing. So I would definitely advise you to just do that anyway, because the practice exams that they have are very well done. And I took those, as well as I also paid for Tutorial Dojo's practice exams for the ACE as well. When it came down to trying to fill in the gaps of my knowledge, you know, I always go straight back to Tutorial Dojo. So they have a cheat sheets available for Google Cloud Services, and they're very, very, very well done as well. So I would highly recommend you take a look at the cheat sheets by Tutorial Dojo's, the practice exams that they made for this exam, and the practice exams that are associated with this course on ExamPro's website. All right, so now that we've talked a little bit about the resources that I used to pass this exam, let me talk a little bit about the study schedule that I had. So I'm gonna tell y'all right now, it wasn't consistent, or I really wasn't consistent studying for this exam. So that's why it took me close to like 3 months to prepare for it. So I started the course for this exam in late May, and then I didn't finish it until mid-July. And then between mid-July and the tail end of August, that was the time where I was just basically going through, reading through the cheat sheets, taking the practice exams, and also playing around with the services and deploying things. So speaking about deploying things, what I actually did, and I spent a pretty decent amount of time, was actually going through the Cloud Resume API challenge that was hosted by Rashab and Ifani. I'm going to drop both of the YouTube channels in the description, but to be honest with you, this challenge allowed me to be able to really practice what it is that I've been studying within Google Cloud by creating an API that people can call to get my resume in JSON format. All right, so now that we covered my study schedule a bit, let's talk about some of the things that you should focus on to really pass this exam. So one thing you should focus on is cloud functions. You definitely want to know a lot about PubSub, all things billing and IAM. You definitely want to have a good handle on App Engine. You definitely want to know a little bit about, as well as Deployment Manager. You want to know Cloud Run, GKE, and Kubernetes fundamentals. You definitely want to take a look at gcloud CLI, really, really play with it. Dataproc, Bigtable, Firestore, Cloud RDS, Cloud Spanner, VPC, and Cloud DNS. Those are the things that you really should look into and really, really focus on for this exam. And that wraps up this video, y'all. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please make sure you like, subscribe, and drop a comment below. Let me know what else you would like to see on this channel and what you think of this video. If you have any friends who are scheduled to take this exam or who are planning to take this exam, definitely send this video to them as well. Again, thank y'all so much for watching, and I can't wait to see y'all in the next video. Later.